Hey y'all, it's me, Cheesy Panini. A couple of weeks ago, I was approached by a viewer who asked if I was planning to make a tutorial on resource packs, and I thought it would be a really helpful video to make. Most of the resources and information covered in this video are based on Blind Force's official resource pack guide, which I'll be linking down in the description below. This video will mostly cover the basics, and all the advanced stuff and in-depth details will be in that guide, so be sure to check it out later. First off, what are the resource packs and how do they differ from mods? A mod is an alteration by players or fans of one or more aspects of a video game. The alterations can be internal, which requires coding and changes how the game works, can be external, which only changes the appearance, sounds, and even dialogue of the game, or both. A resource pack, on the other hand, only changes the external aspects. I would also like to note that mods and resource packs can only be used for the PC version of Terraria. There are four types of resource packs used for Terraria. Texture packs, which replaces in-game sprites and graphics for NPCs, items, enemies, and UI elements, to name a few. Music packs, which are used to replace the music of the game. Sound packs, which are used to replace the sound effects of the game. And language packs, which can modify in-game text in one or more languages, which are used for adding your own translations, changing NPC dialogues, or just changing what the items are called. How do you download and install a resource pack? There are two ways to do this. The first is by downloading a resource pack, then manually placing them inside your resource packs folder. Depending on what operating system you have, you can find them in different locations. If you are playing the GOG version of Terraria, this is unfortunately the only way for you to install your resource packs. The second way is by visiting the Steam Workshop through Terraria's community hub, finding a texture pack you like, and just clicking subscribe. This will make the texture pack usable in your game. How do you enable the resource pack? Once you've gotten the one you wanted, you can go inside the game, select the resource pack you wanted from the left side, and click the red arrow button to move it to the right to enable it. When you open your game again, you should be able to see the changes. But what if you have more than one texture pack that have similar sprites? Say for example, both texture packs you installed have the slime sprite. The game will prioritize or read the slime sprite of the texture pack at the top first, and then just use the textures of the second pack that the first one doesn't have. How do you create a resource pack? Before I tell you how to make the content for it, let me show you how to make the pack to ensure that it will work properly. There are a couple of things you need for your resource pack: a base folder structure format, a JSON file, content that you want to use to replace things in the game, and an icon, which is optional. First off, the base structure format. To make this easy, Blind Force has created a basic testing pack that he has provided in his guide, which you can download down in the description below. Once you've downloaded the pack and extracted it, you will see three items: content folder, icon.png, and pack.json. The content folder has a folder for images, localization, and music. In the images folder, you will see the different folders that are also in your content folder inside your Terraria game folder. There are two logos there that are just there for testing purposes, so feel free to remove that along with the folders you don't need. Now for the pack.json file, you can easily open this up in your Notepad or text edit applications. When you open it, this is what you will see. The only thing you would need to change is the name of the pack, your name or the author's name, and the description. You can also change the version number of your pack if you have several versions of it. For the icon, you don't really need to have one, but it will definitely make your texture pack stand out. There isn't a specific size for it, but the system will resize it to 60 by 60 pixels, so keep that in mind so you can avoid stretching or distortions. And now for the actual content. The process is a little different for each type of resource pack. Texture packs. Terraria sprites are all stored as XNB files and can be found in the images folder inside Terraria's content folder. There are a couple of requirements for a texture pack to work properly. You must use the .png file format, must have the exact same resolution as the sprite being replaced, must have the exact same name as the sprite to be replaced, and must be located in the same subfolder of the images directory that is being replaced. In short, you have to copy the exact arrangement, resolution, and name of everything and make sure it is in a .png format. But Cheesy, how will we even be able to get the original sprites when we can't even open the .xnb files? Worry not, because a Terrarian by the name of Trigger underscore Segfault created a tool that can easily do that for you. You can check out the link to that in the description down below. When you open tconvert, you will see this window. In the Extract tab, all you need to do is keep images checked. Click Use Terraria for the input folder and select your output folder, which is anywhere you want, and voila, you've got your files. This tool can also convert your files back to .xnb, but for making texture packs, this isn't necessary. Now that you have your files, what do you use to edit them? There are many different types of sprite editing tools. I personally use Azaprite, which is a paid program which is also available on Steam. But if you're looking for a free one, which is pretty popular among pixel artists, Pisco is a good choice. Laneforce actually has a list of alternative programs in his guide if neither of these are to your liking. Here are a couple of tips for making your sprites. If the sprite is animated, it helps to copy all the frames and put them on separate frames or layers on top of each other, so it's easy to see if it's off by a pixel or if it moves correctly, and just arrange them back on the sheet when you're done. Terraria uses 2x2 block sprites. This means you can make even more detailed sprites by drawing in 1x1 block pixels, or you can resize this in half and draw with 1x1 pixel, then resize it back to make it easy to be consistent with the pixel size. Your texture pack doesn't have to be pixel art. In fact, one of our TerraCore members, Dante Rice Art, drew the sprites in a different style. You just have to make sure that it's in the same size as the sprites. Some sprites for NPCs use black and white images and are colored with code instead because they use the same sprite for several NPCs, so keep that in mind when making certain sprites. To make sprite making a lot simpler and easier, Laneforce also provided a sprite template on his guide, and you can find the link to it in the description as well. Now, for the case of the person who messaged me, if you want to make wires or anything invisible in the game, all you have to do is find a sprite sheet that corresponds to those wires, delete everything, and put it in a texture pack. Music packs. For music packs, it's pretty straightforward, and the simplest one to create and modify. Here are a couple of things to keep in mind. You can use .wav, .mp3, and .ogg vorbis music files. Be sure to rename your music files to the corresponding music file they are replacing. You can determine the names from the list that Laneforce has listed on his guide. As for music making software, I personally like using GarageBand and Bosca Seoi. And Dante, on the other hand, recommends Jumbus. They're all free, but GarageBand only works in Apple devices, and some features of it is paid. Sound packs. For sound packs, the process is a little similar to texture packs, where you have to use tconvert to extract the sounds from XMB files and change them to WAV files. Just like music packs, you can use .wav, .mp3, and .ogg vorbis music files, and you have to rename your track to the corresponding sound file you are replacing. Dante recommends Chiptone by SFB Games for making custom sound effects. Unfortunately, I haven't found a sound ID list, and there's not much info about it in the wiki saying which sound is which. If any of you guys have a list or know where I can find a list, please let me know down in the comments below. Language packs can be made with JSON files or CSV files. JSON files are created with word processing programs like Notepad or TextEdit and takes on this format of lines of code. CSV files are also created by the same software but in a different format that can be created and opened by spreadsheet programs like Excel or Google Sheets. When created in a Notepad, the columns are separated by commas. You are free to use either of them, but CSV files are generally easier to understand and work with. Terraria has several different language options that are stored in a special file system which is organized into several categories. Each language is its own dedicated file structure. This means if, say, you want to change a name of one of the items in the game, like, say, a blue jay, and you wanted it to be called Divine Beast from now on, you will have to make a file for each language. All text within a language is organized into categories. The first word in the start of the code and the first part of the word in the key column is the category. Every line of text within a category has an internal name or key that the game uses to find the text that goes with it. This text never changes. The word next to the key in the JSON file and the word under the translation column is the text that you can edit. This means when you write down Divine Beast here, when you load up the language pack, all blue jays will now be called Divine Beast in the game. To find the keys and translation of all the text that is currently in the game, you can download the localization CSV file provided by LineForce's guide down in the description below. As for the proper way to name your language packs, you just have to write down the language prefixes that correspond to the language and add any kind of name you want. So the name would go like EN-US followed by any kind of name you want. A couple of things to note though. You can't add more languages. You can only edit existing ones. You can't add text characters and alphabets that aren't already supported by Terraria's code. Text changes that require special code references to other text that is not already supported will not be able to work. Each language has special rules and syntax, and the game's text system is not programmed to account for this. This one's a little bit difficult to explain, but basically language differences can make things kind of complicated, so it might be best to replace the language that you're most familiar with. Again, I highly recommend that you check out LineForce's guide because it's a lot more complete and covers a lot more things that this video guide does not even cover.
I hope this video helped, and I hope that you have fun playing around with resource packs for Terraria. If you enjoyed this video, please leave a like, comment what you think, and subscribe for more. And if you want to support me further, consider checking out my Patreon, Ko-fi, Redbubble, and my commissions page on my site. But for now, I'm just gonna go do my thing, and you guys do your thing, and I'll see you guys later. Take it easy. Stay cheesy.